Hi friends, today we will discuss about MuleSoft. What are the prerequisites for learning MuleSoft? To learn MuleSoft, we should know programming like Java, .NET and PHP, and also we should have experience on Java or any other object oriented language, and basic understanding of data formats such as XML, CSV and JSON. Based on these data formats, we'll exchange the data between multiple systems and multiple applications. Basic understanding of integration technologies like HTTP, JMS, JDBC, REST and SOAP. Like here, the HTTP is a protocol and the JMS is also one of the kind of protocol. JDBC is to connect to database from any programming applications. From Java, I want to connect to any database to select data, process data into database. We'll use JDBC, and REST and SOAP are web services. This is representational state transfer protocol, and the SOAP is simple object application protocol. Yeah, in the next slide we will discuss more about these things. What is web services? Web service is a piece of software that makes itself available over the internet and uses a standard XML messaging system. XML is used to encode all communications to a web service. A web service is a collection of open protocols and standards used for exchanging data between applications or systems. See, here we have two types of web services. Like one is RESTful web services and another one is SOAP based web services. RESTful web services means it's a lightweight, our HTTP protocol, it will work, and we can send different type of data formats like XML, JSON, or text file, or CSV data, some text, whatever you want, we can send. But if we use SOAP based web services, we should follow the some structured data. That is nothing but XML. XML is majorly used in the SOAP based protocols. See, web services offers many benefits over the types of distributed computer architecture. See, here distributed computing means nothing but we have multiple systems. Like one system want to connect to another system. Suppose I have a application which is developed on Java, and I have another application which is developed on .NET. I want to connect to the .NET application. See, here we through web services we will consume the services which has provided by .NET. We will use those services. Like this, using web services we will connect and we will get the data from the other system. Like this way we have multiple systems, like enterprise systems are there, SAP system are there, CRM systems are there, and SAP systems, we want to connect to those systems. We need to make a connection to that system. Thus that system may require different format of data. Based on the given data, we will convert that data into desired format, and we will connect to the different systems. That is nothing but interoperability. This is the most important benefit of web services. Like different systems uses their own data format. If we want to access those systems, we use web services. to get some data or to consume data or to provide data, whatever. Using web services, we'll achieve the benefit. And then usability. Web services allows the business logic of many different systems to the exposed over the web. Then see here, we will discuss about web services. Why means before go through MuleSoft or muleESB or any ESB. If you want to work on any other ESB platforms, ESB software, we should know the basic things like why we have web services, where we exactly use web services in the enterprise application system, what is the use of web services. These things we should know before go through the MuleSoft. And why ESB is coming into the picture. It is a enterprise service bus. It is used for middleware tools, distribute work among connected components of the application. This is designed to communicate with multiple systems. Like, let me explain with a diagram, then everyone can easily understand. See, I have multiple systems. This is, let me zoom out. Don't want this. So now, so I can see. This is my Java. This is another system, .NET system is there. This is another PHP system is there. This is SAP system. This is some CRM system. This is some ERP system. See, I want to talk to these systems. Directly, we can, this is point to point way we can connect.